Well, what's up, everybody?
What's up?
Welcome to another Victory Group.
Yes.
We are so excited that you're in group today.
Yes, yes.
If you're a repeat offender,
attender,
we are so appreciative of you being committed to be in group.
Amen.
Because our church is growing, and as we get larger, small groups is what?
Helps us stay smaller.
Stay smaller. Mm-hmm. And if you're a first-time attender, man, thank you for checking out Small Group. And I know you're going to enjoy yourself. I was going to say, I hope you do. I know you're going
yes.
to. And we pray that you get connected in the Small Group because it's one of the ways we walk with each other and build community.
Mm-hmm.
And so let's dive in. We just launched a brand new series. And we always, I sound like it's like a broken record because we say it all the time, but this series is awesome.
Yeah, you never know, you know, how it can get better, better, gooder,
gooder and gooder,
you know, but
yeah.
it really does.
We went from healing for your soul.
Healing for your soul.
And now
soul.
People are like, man, this was so good, but how's it going to be better? But we started a series entitled Me versus Me. Winning the War Within, because it really is the greatest fight of all time.
Yes.
And man, this series, we just started it. This series is so good. It's going to be so fantastic. And, you know, because it's a real application thing.
Mm-hmm.
This thing, man, about this battle on the inside, and we started in Romans 7. We're not going to read all of it, but Paul talks about it. Paul was like, listen, I done did all this wonderful stuff. I've written a lot of the Bible. People have gotten healed. But he's like, man, there's nothing good inside of me.
Yeah.
He says, the things I shouldn't do,
I do.
And what I you know, should do, I don't do. And it goes on to say, I've discovered that there's a war on the inside. There's this war going on the, I should play that song, War. Huh. What is it good for? Watch.
Absolutely nothing.
That's right. Come on, y'all. Yeah. But that's what he's saying. It like he's saying, it don't matter your title. God can use you.
Yes.
And next thing you know, there's this battle on the inside. And this whole thing is about how you got to be careful that you don't self-sabotage. Because you could be sabotaging yourself, man.
Oh, yes.
Because we've life is choice driven. You know,
yes.
we live and die by the choices that we make. And, you know, you can be your own worst enemy. You can be
yes.
your own worst enemy
yes.
by the self-sabotaging choices that you're making that causes you, man, to not experience God's best.
Yeah. Well, you know, the enemy, he is so swift.
Yeah.
That's the first word that just came
but,
to
no,
my
he
mind.
Is.
He's so
he is.
Swift. You know, and he comes in, especially you could be feeling all good, thinking you're doing good, and he come in and, you know, put all kinds of thoughts, you know, in your mind, you know, which is why, though, the Bible is so clear that we have to cast down every vain imagination that exalts itself
yes.
against the knowledge
yes.
of God. Because the enemy will try to come in and just do whatever to try to get you off your square.
Yeah.
And it becomes a battle, you
yes.
know, against
yeah.
me versus, like you're saying, me versus me, you know, and but we got to know what we need to do to pick ourselves back up.
And one of the things we brought out,
keep the fight going on.
Yeah, one of the things you and I brought out on Sunday is, you know, because we can be so quick to blame the devil. You know, there's a guy named Flip Wilson back in the day. You probably don't know him.
I love Flip
the devil
Wilson.
Made me do it. You know, devil made me do it. Some of y'all, depending on your age, you remember that. Some
you
of you are like, who?
Say that. The
there's
devil
a guy named Flip Wilson.
It.
Yeah, there was. You know, and you
he
know,
was. He was actually. Who was the other person that passed away? He was
Red
his
Fox.
Mentor. Red. Not Red Fox. He was probably.
All right,
Red
not
Fox.
Richard
Red
Pryor.
Red Fox was his mentor.
Oh.
Yeah. Richard Pryor. I think he was Richard Pryor's mentor.
But, you know, one of the things, you know, that whole thing, the devil made me do it. And the devil had me mess up and slip up. And that can be true. But this whole thing about self-sabotage is really not about the devil.
Mm-mm.
It's not about your haters. This is about you.
Mm-hmm.
This is about you and you making decisions to sabotage yourself and ultimately hinder yourself from God's best.
Because regardless, we have a choice.
Yes.
Regardless of the enemy, the thoughts, or whatever, you have a choice on what you choose to do.
Yes.
And how you choose to respond, how you choose to react.
100%. So let's read the definition. We normally don't read definition, but this is a good one on self-sabotage.
Yeah.
So the people, when we keep saying these words, self-sabotage, what do we mean by that?
We said that self-sabotage is the self-destructive decision-making process where a person is being influenced by their flesh to make choices that are against their own best interests and well-being.
Wow, that's a good definition. Self-destructive decision-making process. Self-destructive decision-making process where you're being influenced by your flesh. And we took some time to establish that because people either don't know what that means about your flesh getting the best of you, or they've heard spiritual terms, walk in the spirit and you won't fulfill the lust of the flesh. That sounds cute, but they don't know what that means, self-application, or people think the flesh is this. And one of the things we said on Sunday, this is skin. This is not what the Bible means, flesh. We found out, and according to Romans 8, we're not going to go there, that the flesh, but Romans 8, if you missed one of the last messages, go check them out, the current one. But the flesh is a way of thinking.
It's a way of thinking
that goes against God's word and really waits for opportunities to influence your perception and your decision-making and persuade you to really go against the will of God. The flesh is thinking. It's a fleshy way of thinking that goes against the word of God, just like walking in the spirit. Romans 8 says, is a way of thinking that lines up with God's words. And so this whole thing about self-sabotage is about how you think.
Mm-hmm.
It's about how you think, because your flesh is a hot mess. And if you miss service, man, we did an illustration.
Yes.
We did an illustration, man, depending when you're looking at it, the first lesson in this series, we did an illustration. We had a boxing ring up on the platform and we showed that, you know, me versus me is really you versus three of you.
Yes.
Three of you. And it's really, you know, it's really about your thoughts, your tongue, and your temperament. You know, that your fleshy thoughts can really take you down a dark road.
Mm-hmm.
Your fleshy tongue can be your worst, you know, enemy. The life and death is in the power of the tongue, and we eat the fruit thereof. Your fleshy tongue can cause you to reap some stuff you didn't want to reap. And then your fleshy temperament.
Mm-hmm.
Your attitude. If you got a stank, did he say that? A stank attitude, man, it can cause you just to sabotage yourself. And so when we're talking about the flesh, we're talking about your thoughts, your tongue, and your temperament. But the Bible's clear that the way to not let your flesh dominate you is to be renewed in your thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Romans 12:2 says, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. For what purpose? So you can identify the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. In other words, you renew your thinking so that in spite of what you're thinking, in spite of your thoughts, you can still choose God's best for your life. Renew your thinking, because in spite of your tongue and your temperament, you can still choose God's best for your life.
Amen.
I think one of the things we showed, man, is Romans 8 said that the flesh does not have to have claims on us. In other words, listen to us. It is possible for you to go from being dominated by your flesh to dominate your flesh. So that now, me versus me, the fleshy you is not dominate you, because you've renewed your mind in the word of God, and you're hanging out with different people. You're in different environments, and all of them affect how you process, which then affects your thinking, affects your tongue, and affects your attitude.
Amen.
This
Amen.
Is a great series, man.
Amen.
Woo! There's so much we got to cover in this.
So
we're just getting started.
Yes.
So listen, you know what we always do during these small group sessions. We're going to give you some questions in a minute that pertain to the mess, to, you know, what we talked about, the lesson from Sunday and what we talked about tonight. And we're going to get everybody involved in asking the questions. You're not going to sit there and let everybody else talk. No, you're not. You're going to share as well. But before we do that, we have a video. This video is close to my heart. There's a video, man. This is coming from a movie called Rudy. Do y'all remember Rudy? I don't know if you remember. If you don't, you should go watch it. This is a clip from Rudy. And really, Rudy, man, is being dealt with by someone who becomes a mentor, so to speak, or coach to him, and really talking about how he's hindering himself. He's hurting himself. So I want you to check this video out. Then I want you to go watch the movie later on, because you'll love it.
It's a good family movie.
It's a great movie. Yeah. And then once we're out of the clip, we're going to come back. We're going to throw the questions up. The facilitator will pause this, the you know, video, pause us. And now everybody get involved in answering the questions, because what you share is not just going to help you, man. It's going to help somebody else.
Amen.
So this has been great, man. It went by way too fast. It's been great. Make sure you stay in touch with all of our social media platforms and the website, because we got so much stuff going on to help you experience victory in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Well, we always close this way. We say you can look up, down, in, out, high, low, all around, but you'll find victory only one place in the entire universe. Where is that, Mamacita?
In Christ Jesus.
Be blessed.
Be blessed.
Make sure the top's ready. We'll check with the weather service by 5, and we'll make a decision then. Hey. What you doing here? Don't you have practice?
Not anymore. I quit.
Oh. Well, since when are you the quitting kind?
I don't know. I just don't see the point anymore.
So you didn't make the dress list. There are greater tragedies in the world.
I wanted to run out of that tunnel for my dad. To prove to everyone that I worked...
Prove what?
That I was somebody.
Oh, you are so full of crap. You're 5 feet nothing. 100 and nothing. And you got hardly a speck of athletic ability. And you hung in with the best college football team in the land for 2 years. And you're also gonna walk out of here with a degree from the University of Notre Dame. In this lifetime, you don't have to prove nothing to nobody except yourself. And after what you've gone through, if you haven't done that by now, it ain't gonna never happen. Now go on back.
Sorry, I never got you to see your first game in here.
Hell, I've seen too many games in this stadium.
I thought you said you never saw a game.
I've never seen a game from the stands.
You were a player?
I rode the bench for 2 years. Thought I wasn't being played because of my color. I got filled up with a lot of attitude. So I quit. Still not a week goes by, I don't regret it. And I guarantee a week won't go by in your life. You won't regret walking out, letting them get the best of you. You hear me clear enough? Thank you.